Hey guys, welcome back to War on Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you that have any of the following three cars guys. I'm talking about Ram Pro Master City, Fiat 500X and Fiat Toro. What's common between all of these guys? The engine that we have right here. This is the 2.4 liter multi-air engine guys. You can find that in each of these cars. Now, if you guys have engine light on and code such as P2096, stay with us guys and we will explain what causes that and how to fix that. In some cases, you may even have a second code which is P0100. So, in today's video guys, we will explain what causes that, how to fix it. In rare cases, you can even see code P0420 and we're going to explain why. So make sure you stay until the end. There is a few scenarios that can cause that. Now, before we start guys, the engine is out of the car. Why? We did an engine replacement. In the meantime, we made about 100 videos guys, how to remove and replace every component. Now we're in the process of making another 100 videos for common problems, engine codes and diagnostics. Why we do all that? Because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. So, let us show you, okay, what we have here. This is the engine guys. This is 2.4 liter multi-air engine out of the car. Now, if you guys have code P2096, okay, that indicates that the downstream oxygen sensor is detecting that the car is running lean. Running lean guys, okay, means that the car is getting more air and less fuel. Okay, more air, less fuel. That's why it's lean mixture. What can lead to that guys? Vacuum leak. Vacuum leak can cause that. Number two guys, it can be, okay, it can be guys, some models will have mass airflow sensor. This is the device that detects how much air your car is getting. Or some models that don't have the MAF sensor, they will have a MAP sensor. This is the manifold absolute pressure sensor. These two sensors detect how much air your car is getting. So if they're not performing correctly guys, you can get that code as well. Because let's say the mass airflow sensor is reading that the engine is getting 10 grams of air per second, but actually it's getting 15 grams because it doesn't know about the other 5 grams. Okay, it's going to spray fuel for 10 grams, but the engine is getting 15 grams of air and that will result into a lean mixture. So, if you have code P0100 guys, together with the other code, check the MAF sensor, clean it. We have a video on the channel that explains how to clean one. And if that doesn't fix the problem, replace it. Now, in some cases you may get code P0420. P0420 indicates that you have a bad catalytic converter, guys. And bad catalytic converter can throw that code 2096 as well. But the most common thing, guys, is that we see here at the shop, okay, is a bad oxygen sensor, downstream oxygen sensor. Next scene, you're going to see the engine when we got it out of the car, still with the black cover, guys, okay, and we'll show you where that downstream oxygen sensor is located and what needs to be done, guys, to remove and replace it. So, let's continue now. Coming down, guys, this is your exhaust manifold right here. And facing this way, okay, the first sensor is known as upstream oxygen sensor or sensor 1. This sensor now guys tells the engine how much air, how much fuel to adjust and all that stuff. The second sensor is on the right side, okay, right here. And this is the one guys, okay, that actually is responsible for the mixture, for the catalytic converter, excuse me. That one tells, okay, the computer if the catalytic converter is performing correct. So, how you guys remove and replace those things? Right here you can see you have the wire, okay. The white wire is for the downstream oxygen sensor. Press down here. Okay, pull it out guys, just like that. After that, okay, let me show you what else we'll need to use. There is a special socket for removing oxygen sensors. And it's pretty handy using that socket. Otherwise guys, you can damage the sensor and at that point you won't be able to remove it and it will be a big mess. You might need to buy a new exhaust manifold. So that socket, you can find the link in the description of the video below guys. Okay, what do? You get through the wires. Okay, check out how you go through the wires. That's amazing. You go on the side of it, okay, and you just remove it guys. Might be really tight. It really depends when was last time it was removed. Those things will get super tight sometimes. This one wasn't so bad. Go ahead, unscrew it. Okay guys, this is the sensor right here, you can see. So that's how you guys remove it. Practically not too bad, right? If you need to buy one, we have the link in the description of the video below. In addition guys, okay, Installation practically is in reverse order, we took it apart. So, as you can see, that's how you guys remove and replace the downstream oxygen sensor. Putting it together is in reverse order. We took it apart, check out all three channels that we have, guys. The first one, auto repair, guys, we have helped more than 65 million people, so please check it out. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.